Welcome to Moo Moo Math and Science. In this video, let's go over how to measure with a ruler, and let's measure in inches. To begin with, what do all these lines represent? So let's break this down. Okay, if you look here, it begins at 0, and then you have a 1, 2, and a 3. Each of these will represent 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, etc. Next, you'll notice and see a 1 half. If you'll notice this line, and many times for 1 half, it's a little bit larger, it divides this section into two parts. And just like a fraction, remember, it's a part of a whole. So it is one part of the whole, which is divided into two parts. So it represents 1 half. Then look at the 1/4. Notice that it divides it into four equal parts. So this first is 1/4 because it divides it into one of four parts. Then we have 2/4, which if you reduce this is 1/2. Then 3/4, and then 4/4, which is 1. So now let's see if we can apply this to some measurements. With this first measurement, notice we're going to start at 0, and it extends out to the 2. So this first measurement is 2 inches. Okay, with this one, let's begin at 0, and it goes past the 1 and the 2, and notice that it goes to the 1/2 mark. And notice that the 1/2 mark is a little bit larger. That's not always the case, but with many rulers, that's what you will see. So this measurement is 2.5 inches. Okay, with this one, we start at 0. It goes past the 1, and it goes to this first smaller tick mark. And remember, it represents 1/4 because it divides it up into four equal parts. So this would be 1.75 inches. I hope you're beginning to get the hang of this. With this one, let's start at 0. It goes past the 1, the 2, and the 3. Then it goes past the 1/2, and it's at the third 1/4 mark. So this will be 3.75. Okay, what about this one? Notice that it does not go to the 1, so it's going to be smaller than an inch. Let's review. Notice that the smaller marks, we have 1/4, then 1/2, and 3/4. The 1/2 divides it into two equal parts. The 1/4 divides it into four equal parts. This is at the third mark, so it's going to be 3/4 of an inch. Again, I hope by now you're getting this. If you look at this one, let's start at 0. It goes past the 1, it goes past the 2, and it goes to this first mark, and we know that it divides it into four equal parts, so it will be 2.75 inches. Now let's try some measurements on our own. This first one, take a look. And is it 1.5 or 1.75? It's 1.75 because it goes to the third 1/4 mark. This next one, is it 1.75 inches or 1.5 inches? It's 1.5 inches. This next one, is it 3/4 of an inch or 1.25 of an inch? It's 3/4 of an inch. How about this one? 2.75 or 3.75? You're correct if you said it's 3.75 inches in length.